Welcome back dear students. In first lecture we saw basic terms like distance, displacement, speed, velocity, instantaneous and average. Okay, let's continue our discussion from there. Average velocity and average speed. Average speed is equal to total distance upon total time. Okay, average velocity magnitude is total displacement upon total time magnitude of total displacement. Okay, let's say in case number one, they have given us displacement and time. Okay, in this case average velocity or speed, because it is continuously moving in straight line, average velocity or speed is s1 plus s2 plus s3 divided by t1 plus t2 plus t3. Okay, in case there was also some returning back s4 in time t4, then average speed would be still s4 plus t4, but velocity average would become s1 plus s2 plus s3 minus s4, because now it has returned, divided by t1 plus t2 plus t3 plus t4. Remember, time will still increase even if it is returning back plus t4. Okay, now in this case displacement and time were given. In case number 2, let's say they have given displacement and speed. S2 V2, S3 V3, some returning back S4 at velocity speed V4. Okay, let's say in this case they have mentioned displacements and speed. In this case average speed is total distance S1 plus S2 plus S3 plus S4 divided by total time. Now I need to find time for all of these intervals. Okay, how to find time? I know displacement, I know speed, I can find t1 time is s11 by v1 plus t2 time is s2 by v2. Displacement upon speed is time plus s3 by v3 plus s4 by v4. Now everything will be plus in case of average speed, and in case of average velocity magnitude, that will be s1 plus s2 plus s3 minus s4 divided by times will be s1 by v1 plus s2 by v2 plus s3 by v3. So in any case we have to the formula is only total distance upon total time, or total displacement upon total time. Okay, even if there is no a distance is not given, I have to find a distance. If time is not given, as in this case, I have to find time. Time is s1 by v1 plus s2 by v2 plus s3 by v3 plus s4 by v4. Okay, quickly note down this: average speed and average velocity, vector velocity, magnitude, average. Okay, after this let's also see case number 3 and case number 4. Okay, in case number 3, let's say displacement is not given, velocity and time are given. v1 v2 v3 v4. Okay, in this case average velocity is total displacement upon total time. Time is given but displacements are not given. So how to find these displacements? I know displacement is velocity into time, so it becomes v1 t1 plus v2 t2 plus v3 t3 with speed into time is distance, v4 t4. Okay, in case of velocity there will be minus v4 t4. v1 t1 plus v2 t2 plus v3 t3 minus v4 t4. Okay, now this was case number 3. What is case number 4? Case number 4 can be that some random things are given. For example, in first case displacement and time are given. In second case displacement and velocity are given. In third case velocity and time are given. In fourth case again velocity and displacement are given. So in this case average is velocity is total displacement s1, total distance s1 plus s2 plus, here distance is not given, distance is speed into time, plus v3 t3 plus distance is s4 divided by time t1 plus, time is not given, time is s2 by v2 plus t3, again time is not given, s4 by v4. In all these cases, if you pay attention, there is no other formula but total distance upon total time or total displacement upon total time. So what is average velocity? Displacement s1 plus s2 plus v3 t3 minus s4 divided by total time t1 plus s2 by v2 plus t3 plus s4 by v4. Okay, case number 4 is combination of any of two physical quantities for interval, any two, distance time, speed time, or distance speed. Okay, you will find these questions in DBP. I hope you will be able to solve all of them. Let's continue from here. Let's say this is a question. A particle moves half distance at speed v1, next half distance in two equal in time intervals at speed v2 and v3. Find average speed. So let's say this is total distance. Half of the distance is x by 2 and remaining half of the distance is x by 2. First half distance it moved at time at speed v1. Next half distance in two equal time intervals, let's say two equal in time intervals were t and t, okay, at speed v1 and at speed v2. Okay, I need to find average speed. Average speed is total distance. Total distance is x by 2 plus x by 2 is x upon total time. Total time is, time taken here is distance upon speed. Distance upon speed is x by 2 v1. X by 2 v1 plus time here is t plus t 2t. T plus t 2t. Okay, next. let's see how much distance did it cover here and how much distance did it cover here, because their sum should be equal to x by 2. Distance it covered in first interval was v1t. Distance it covered in second displacement was, second time interval was v2t. v1t plus v2t must also be equal to x by 2. So from here I can say t is equal to x by 2 v1 plus v2. Time interval is equal to x by 2 v1 plus v2. Let's fill it here. Okay, let's fill it here. I will get x divided by x by 2 v1 plus x by 2 v1 plus v2. So this can be simplified. X is going to cancel out from everywhere. I will get answer in terms of v1 plus v2. 2 is going up. V1 plus v2 plus this one is v2 and v3. V2 and v3. V2, v3, v2, v3. Okay. So it becomes v2 plus v3 plus v1, v1 plus v2 plus v3 divided by v1 into v2 plus v3, which will become here in multiplication. It will become v1 into v2 plus v3. So this is the answer of average speed. Sorry, this is t, but we need to fill 2t. So here it will be 2 by 2, which means it will become 2v1. 2v1 v2 plus v3 divided by 2v1 plus v2 plus v3. Okay. If this is the question, position of a particle is given by this equation. Even then they can ask find average velocity and average speed and average velocity. So let's see if position is given, how to find average velocity and average speed. Second part is very easy. Average velocity is total displacement, final position minus initial position upon total time t. Total time t2 minus t1. Okay, total displacement is final position minus initial position divided by total time t2 minus t1. So final position is, if I am filling here 2, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 by 3 minus 2. This is final position. Initial position was 0 minus 0, 0 divided by total time 2 minus 0, 0. That is equal to 8 minus 6, 2, 2 by 3 divided by 2. So it will become 1 by 3. So it will become 1 by 3 meter per second. Average velocity is very easy. But if I want to find average speed, I need to know what was total distance. Checking total distance, I need to check if it has turned around. I need to check if the body returns in this interval. If it comes back, okay, I need to check. So let's see, if I need to find average speed, I need to check if it has returned back. What is expression of velocity dx by dt? Expression of velocity is 3t square by 3, which is t square minus 1. Now this is expression of velocity. If the velocity changes from positive to negative or negative to positive, it means it has returned from there. If initially velocity was positive and now it becomes a negative, or if initially it was negative, now it becomes positive, it means it has returned. So at time is equal to 0, I saw that velocity is minus 1 meter per second. at time is equal to 2, I saw that velocity is 2 to the 4, 4 minus 1 plus 3 meter per second. It has changed from minus to positive. It means it has returned at some point. Where did it return? Whenever a car has to return back, for example, it is going like this. It has to return back here. Once its speed will become 0 and then it will start moving. Okay, if it is moving like this, if it has to return back, first its speed should become 0, then it will start returning. It cannot return back at very large speed unless it makes a circle and returns. On straight line, if it has to return, it has to stop for a moment and then come back. Okay, on a straight line, it returns so it starts returning it starts returning at the moment when velocity becomes 0. When velocity becomes 0, so when was its velocity 0? T square minus 1 is equal to 0, time is equal to 1 second. So it started returning at time is equal to 1 second. So I know that initially it was moving in negative direction. At time is equal to 1 second, its velocity became 0. At that moment it started returning. Finally its velocity was positive. So now my mission is to find what was its position at time is equal to 1 second. Okay, I'm going to erase most of the part. Okay, it started returning at time is equal to 1 second. At time is equal to 0, its position was 0, 0. At time is equal to 0, its position is x is equal to 0. At time is equal to 1, its position is 1 by 3 minus 1. 1 by 3 minus 1 is, at time is equal to 1, its position is 1 by 3 minus 1 minus 2 by 3. Its position is minus 2 by 3. It means initially it was moving in negative direction and it reached here and then it started returning back. If you remember, its initial velocity was minus 1. It was moving in negative direction. Here its velocity became 0 because here it started returning back and finally it is coming in positive direction. Okay, finally its speed became 3 meter per second. What is its position at time is equal to 2? That is 8 by 3 minus 2. 8 by 3 minus 2 is plus 2 by 3. So at time is equal to 2, its position is plus 2 by 3. Final position minus initial position was this minus this. It did not depend on from where did it return, but in average speed I need to see total distance. Total distance is this, 0 to 2 by 3, distance is 2 by 3 plus this distance again 2 by 3 plus this distance again is 2 by 3. Okay, total distance is 2 by 3 plus 2 by 3 plus 2 by 3 upon total time is 2 seconds. Okay, so total distance upon total time is 6 by 3, which is 2. 2 by 2 is 1 meter per second. Average speed is 1 meter per second. Okay, equation based questions, you need to always check if the body returns in this interval, or you need to check, or in simple words, I need to check if velocity becomes 0 and at the moment when velocity becomes 0, before that was it positive and it became negative, or was it negative or and it became positive. Okay, there might also be equation when it became 0 but still after touching 0 it again stayed from positive to positive, like this. It was going like this, it stopped बट स्टिल अगेन इट स्टार्टेड इन सेम डायरेक्शन और इट वॉज मूविंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन, इट स्टॉप्ड एंड स्टिल इट केप्ट ऑन मूविंग इन. यू ऑल्सो नीड टू सी नॉट ओनली दिस पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव, यू ऑल्सो नीड टू सी when its velocity was zero, did it turn from positive to negative, negative to positive, positive to positive, negative to negative, did it remain from positive to positive, negative to negative, or this was the case. If this was the case, it means it returned back at that moment. Okay, question can also be graph based. For example, for this graph, velocity time graph, whose velocity changes like this, find average speed from time is equal to 0 to time is equal to 6 or average velocity from time is equal to 0 to time is equal to 6 seconds. The solution is based on simple definitions. Average speed is total distance upon total time. Okay, now distance is area under this graph. Distance is area under this graph, all area positive. Okay, all area should be considered positive. So it is 10 into 2, 20, plus half base into height, half 2 into 10 is half, 2 into 10 is 10, plus half 2 into, let's say this is also minus 10. So half 2 into minus 10 is into 10. Okay, all areas should be considered positive. Upon total time is 6. So it becomes 20, 30, 40, 40 by 6 meters per second, or 20 by 3 meters per second. But in average velocity, when we are checking displacement, total displacement upon total time, in this case I need to check positive or negative area. Okay, this area is positive, this area is positive, this area is negative when we are considering displacement. So it becomes 20 plus 10 minus 10 by 6. So if you see, its velocity was positive, again its velocity is positive but decreasing, velocity became 0, here its velocity became 0. Now it is moving in negative direction. Negative velocity means it is moving in negative direction. Okay, so it has returned back. I need to subtract this displacement, 20 plus 10 minus 10. So it returned back this distance. Okay, so 20 plus 10 minus 10 is 20 by 6 or 10 by 3 meter per second. Okay, this is very easy question. Okay, our next topic of discussion is acceleration. Rate of change of velocity is called as, acceleration is rate of change of velocity. It is a vector quantity. Okay, it depends on frame of reference. It depends on observer. Okay, now there is instantaneous acceleration and also average. Instantaneous acceleration is dv by dt given by derivative, and average acceleration is total change in velocity upon total time. Total change in velocity upon total time, which can also be written as final velocity minus initial velocity, vector form, divided by total time, let's say t. Okay, v is generally used as final velocity and u is used for initial velocity. Used for initial velocity. You also know from vector subtraction, if this is u, this is v at some angle theta, at some angle theta. In that case v minus u has a value equal to v square plus u square minus 2vu cos theta. This is magnitude of vector a minus vector b, v square plus u square minus 2vu cos theta, if theta is the angle between these two vectors. Okay, so these are some ways in which question can be asked in terms of instantaneous acceleration or in terms of average acceleration. Okay, let's say question is vector r is a sin t minus b cos t j cap, a sin t I cap minus b cos t j cap. I need to find what is acceleration. Okay, from position I can find velocity is dr by dt, which is a, derivative of sin t is cos t I cap, minus b, derivative of cos t is minus sin t, so it becomes plus sin t j cap. This is dr by dt is velocity. Okay, acceleration is dv by dt or second order derivative of position, d square r by dt square. So second derivative is again derivative of this, a cos t has derivation a minus a sin t I cap, and sin t has derivative cos t plus b cos t j cap, plus b cos t j cap. If you see this thing, if I take minus common, I have a sin t I cap minus b cos t j cap. If I'm taking minus common, I'm getting r. So acceleration can be written as minus r. Angle between acceleration and r in this case is 180 degrees. Okay, in case of sine and cos, if equation is based on sine and cos, then usually angle between acceleration and r is 180 degrees. As you can clearly see, they're exactly equal but opposite. If you remember, I shown you one question in which u was in this direction, v was in this direction. This was our point, that sometimes final velocity will not be in same direction as initial velocity. The direction is also going to change. Okay, so let's say a body is moving in this direction at velocity, at speed v. A body is moving at this speed v. Okay, acceleration is in some other direction. Acceleration can be in any random direction. Okay, for example, acceleration is in this direction. Acceleration depends on force. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. So if I'm applying force in this direction on this moving body, this body was moving in this path. If force is in this direction, acceleration will also be in this direction. In that case, I need to resolve this acceleration. It has two components. One along the motion, which is called a tangential, and another is normal to the motion, which is a radial, because due to this it will turn in circular path. Okay, it wanted to move in this direction, but what will happen because of this, it will turn its path. Okay, so this is my point of discussion, tangential acceleration and radial acceleration. Tangential and radial acceleration, because acceleration is not always along the motion. Acceleration can be in any random direction. So if in this case force is in this direction, net force is in this direction, acceleration is also in that direction. Okay, it has two components, tangential and radial. Tangential acceleration is responsible for is responsible for इंक्रीजिंग स्लैश डिक्रीजिंग द स्पीड, इंक्रीजिंग स्लैश डिक्रीजिंग द स्पीड. ओके, रेडियल एक्सीलरेशन, रेडियल एक्सीलरेशन, रेडियल एक्सीलरेशन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड सेंट्रीपिटल एक्सीलरेशन, सेंट्रीपिटल एक्सीलरेशन. ओके, इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर change in direction of motion, change in direction of velocity. Okay, it can only change direction, and this one it can increase or decrease the speed. So this is this can work on magnitude, this can work on direction. Both of them are having different objectives. This acceleration cannot, change the direction. This acceleration cannot change the speed. It cannot increase or decrease. This acceleration can only change its path. For example, due to this acceleration, it turned into this curved path. Due to this acceleration, its speed is, in this case, increasing. If net force was in this direction, for example, this was moving in this direction, net force was in this direction, net acceleration would have been in this direction. Okay, in this case, radial acceleration will bring it into circular motion, tangential acceleration will decrease its speed. If you can see, tangential acceleration is slowing it down. Here it will become fast. It will speed up. And here it will slow down. Why? Because tangential acceleration is opposite to velocity. Here, radial acceleration will bring it in circular path, but tangential acceleration will slow it down. Okay? So, tangential acceleration is responsible for increasing or decreasing the speed. Radial acceleration is responsible for change in direction of velocity. Net acceleration is under root this square plus this square. This acceleration plus this acceleration, they both are at 90 degrees. So, their resultant is a tangential square plus a radial square. These are few points which you need to remember for circular motion. Later on we will study circular motion. In that case, we will study this acceleration, centripetal acceleration. Remember few points about centripetal acceleration. It is only responsible for changing direction. It is not responsible for increasing or decreasing the speed. Tangential acceleration increases or decreases the speed. Okay?